So I told the policeman that he had no warrant and no right to take our equipment. And he say he didn't need it. They even took the camera's bag, claiming they didn't know what was inside it, and so it might be dangerous. And the police took Guillaume's two SD cards from his camera. I said they cannot do that without the warrant. The cop, who obviously either doesn't know the law or doesn't care what the law is, arrogantly told me that I was a journalist and not a lawyer. We are going to go as far as we need to go to defend journalistic freedom, because it is one of the most important rights in a free society. We are getting lawyer involved. If you do like to help us protect the right of journalists to work in Canada without harassment or illegal seizure of our property by police, please make a donation to defendjournalists.com to offset our legal costs. If they can do this to us, well, we are holding camera and recording them. Imagine what the police could do to you. Okay, everyone, this is a very serious video because freedom of the press is under attack. If it hadn't happened to me, it would be hard for me to believe. First, I'm going to tell you what happened to us, and then I'm going to ask you to help us. Let me explain. I went to a shopping center in Quebec City with Guillaume, the freelance journalist who often works as my cameraman, except on this day, Guillaume was working for himself. That day, we were covering a protest led by François Maléga, where people were simply going to shop without a mask. They just wanted to assert their right to walk around freely without face covering. But here is where things get crazy for me and my friend. The police were already on scene as François led the demonstration into the Walmart. I fought away because I am a journalist following this story, and so did Guillaume. Totally normal so far. Once inside of the Walmart, the protesters took off their masks, so the police moved in to remove them from the store. François was arrested pretty roughly, and like the journalist that we are, Guillaume and I documented everything. While I was filming the arrest of François, I turned around to realize that Guillaume was surrounded by police. Two of them were grabbing at his camera, asking him to turn it off. We are journalists and we don't turn off our camera for anybody, especially not in a public place where there is no presumption of privacy and a new worthy event is happening. I started filming what was happening to Guillaume because I didn't know if he was able to film or if the police had turned his camera off. One officer ordered Guillaume to turn his camera over to the police so that they could have it for evidence or in court. Since when in Canada do we size journalists' camera for evidence in court? If the police want evidence, they can use their own body camera. They can use the surveillance footage at the Walmart. The only reason to size our footage would be to hide how the police handled the demonstration that day. So I told the policeman that he had no warrant and no right to take our equipment. And he say he didn't need it. They even took the camera's bag, claiming they didn't know what was inside it, and so it might be dangerous. He is a journalist, not a terrorist. We argued for a bit, and the police took Guillaume's two SD cards from his camera. I said they cannot do that without a warrant. The cop, who obviously either doesn't know the law or doesn't care what the law is, arrogantly told me that I was a journalist and not a lawyer. But if he know that I'm a journalist, then he know he cannot take our footage. Then the cop, after illegally seizing our footage, gave Guillaume a ticket of $1,550 for not wearing a mask. We were working. What if I had confidential interview and compromising report on those SD cards? I know we have image of the police misconduct. A journalist, whether independent or not, should never have to turn over their journalistic material to a police officer in a free country. At Ribbon News, we are going to fight to recover our property. This footage and this evidence of the police misconduct. We are also going to do something else. The police need to be reminded that they are not above the law, and we are going to fight to make sure this never happens to me or any other journalist in this country ever again. We must defend freedom of the press and our journalists at all costs. If they can take our footage from our camera in public, what is to stop them from barging into our office or our home studio and doing the same? What is the difference? We are going to go as far as we need to go to defend journalistic freedom, because it is one of the most important rights in a free society. We are getting lawyer involved. If you do like to help us protect the right of journalists to work in Canada without harassment or illegal seizure of our property by police, please make a donation to defendjournalists.com to offset our legal costs. If they can do this to us, well, we are holding camera and recording them. Imagine what the police could do to you. Please go to defendjournalists.com to help us make this right. It was Alexa for Ribbon News.